We're going into a situation this weekend that's very scary for a whole lot of people. I want to read you a quote from a veteran forecaster today. He says, "We are in uncharted territory here. I've never seen anything like this. I'm at a loss for words to describe what this storm could do. Oceans will surge, trees will come down, power will go out, portions of the coastline could be ravaged."
Battered, beaten, and being rescued.
I was scared that I was gonna drown. It was just crazy.
The Category 2 hurricane blasted out winds of over 110 miles per hour and unleashed a staggering 2 feet of rain.
Oh
my God!
Our tree!
You're
what? Our tree!
Oh! Absolute mayhem.
Situations.
There and it's just forcing its way into the bay. Yeah, that's right. It's just incredible. Yeah, you can see where that house is just shifted.
My name is Brendan Barrato. I lived, keyword D, lived in Seaside Heights, New Jersey. The Sunday before the storm hit, my mother and I were just roaming through Target, seeing people get giant cases of water bottles and like get all the milk, like the world was going to end. I didn't know what to think of it. I was like, you know, it was like Irene. Nothing happened. Our street was untouched. It was perfectly fine. So we didn't have any alarm for concern.
I heard about the storm. The storm hit Sunday or Monday. I heard about it Friday at school. And I didn't think anything of it, because nothing happened to me with Irene, so I didn't pack anything.
Then, Monday night, the night the storm hit, my mother and I, we, like, jokingly, like, oh, let's go up to the boardwalk and see all the wind and all the storm. And we saw a few power light, street lights were down, and figured, oh, okay, it's getting pretty bad. Walking back to the house, though, we noticed that the puddles were a lot larger. We didn't know this until a lot later, but the sewers were backing up. And they were coming, floating up the streets. We didn't know, so we just assumed it was the rain, and we rushed back in the house. Within 5 minutes of being in the house, the water was already up to our first step. So we just kind of hung out until around 11:30. That's when we decided, okay, my mother and I will go to bed, and my uncle and my grandmother will stay up, and we'll just take shifts, seeing what's going on. I then wake up 45 minutes later to my mom screaming into my ear, get up, the house is flooding. And I step down, and I'm in 6 inches of water.
And when I went to my dad's house on Friday, and the storm hit Sunday or Monday, And then I found out that, you know, Seaside and most of the Barrier Islands were gone, and I couldn't go back to my house. So I was stuck with no clothes. And then we were able to go back, and the entire first floor was destroyed, 2 feet of water.
I rush out, see what's going on, I look outside. I was baffled. Remember before I mentioned that staircase that was in front of my house that was about 5 feet? The water was about 6 to 7 feet high. And it just kind of washed over and made this basically a pool. It was sewer water. The fact it was that didn't bother me. I was worried about getting my grandmother upstairs because she would have died of hypothermia if we didn't get up there probably.
It was light rain. It didn't seem like an actual storm from where I was, but damage says differently.
So we spent Tuesday cleaning out, and then we went to bed. And then that Wednesday morning, when we woke up, I decided to go, because the water was mostly down by then. It was only like a foot high. So we decided to go walking through the street, see what's going on. We check out the bayside, and then we check the oceanside and the boardwalk. I don't know if I should feel selfish or just feel, I feel worse about the boardwalk being ruined than my own house. That boardwalk, when we got up there, the wood was buckled. It was like a perfect BMX track. Insane. Chunks of it was ripped right out, and it was horrifying. I grew up on that boardwalk, and now it was mostly gone. I went up to where the Coin Castle is, the Coin Castle Arcade. It's around the middle between Funtown Pier, or whatever was left of it, and whatever was left of the casino pier. I wasn't aware of what happened to the other pier, so I just walked to the Funtown Pier. Seeing big chunks taken out of the boardwalk and just everything buckled up. It was unsafe to walk on it, but I figured, why not? When am I ever going to have a chance like this again? I look at the Funtown Pier, and there's the Carousel Arcade. It was devastated. Arcade machines were down there. The boardwalk was chunked out. You can literally look down and see the sand dune. Piles of wood, garbage. Just, it was ravaged. Even though I didn't enjoy living in Seaside, I still loved that boardwalk, and seeing it ripped apart like that, especially that one area, because I have very vivid memories of just that little area, because I used to hang out at the Funtown Pier a lot, a child mostly, and seeing it most of it gone.
Well, my house was raised about a foot, maybe 2 feet off the ground from the cellar. It's still got about 2 feet of water inside of it. There's a watermark in the middle, halfway up our fridge. And there's just mud all over the floor, and the smell is horrible, and there's just mildew and mold everywhere. And there's, like, that's saying something for my house, but some of the other houses in Seaside can't even be accessed yet.
And then I walked to Casino Pier, and I figured, oh, buckled boardwalk, they can fix this. And I look at Funtown Pier, and I look at Casino Pier, and I realize the purple roller coaster is not there. The big purple roller coaster that, if you've been to Seaside, you know that coaster. And then I walk a little more north, and then I see it in the ocean. Whole roller coaster, the ocean. Most of it's still intact. Would you ever, ever in your life imagine something like that? I couldn't at all. One of those rides that plays loud music and spins, I forget the name of it. But that was that whole ride was on the beach. And behind that was the roller coaster just sitting in the ocean, good 20 feet out. I don't know how to feel about that. I still don't. I've just kind of been repressing stuff just to move on with my life, but just that roller coaster is just like I was speechless. I couldn't say a word. I just stared at it. I didn't know what else to think.
Like I said before, it just seemed like rain. There wasn't a lot of wind where I was. We were in a pretty condensed neighborhood, and there was nothing really unusual about it from where we were. There was a couple trees gone, but we didn't lose our power at all. Had power the whole time. So from my perspective, it was like nothing was happening. But But there was, like, a couple of blocks outward, there was, like, at Tom's River, one of my dad's friend's house didn't have power for, like, 3 weeks after the storm. After the storm hit, me and my dad went for a drive, and we tried to go to the island, which we didn't know was blocked off at the time, so we drove to Fisher Boulevard, and it was flooded, about 2 feet of water, and there was boats in the middle of the road. But to see, like, boats and chairs and tables in the middle of a highway where there's no houses, it's weird.
Walked home, and we just stayed at the house for a while. We didn't know what to do. We decided to finally evacuate, and they were letting people out, buses, people taking people out to, I think, Tom's River East. My uncle decided to stay for a day. He ended up leaving the day after us, but he decided to stay and watch the house in case of looters. It was my mother and my grandmother and I. My grandmother couldn't make the walk. We had to end up holding her up for a while. We walked on Route 35 near the bay, where the Stewart's and that park is, where the elementary school is. Chunks of the road are gone, like asphalt is just falling into the ground. There was a pickup truck just literally 90 degree up in a hole. And even walking there, I walked on one part of the street, and literally seconds after I walked on it, the street collapsed. We ended up going to the AMP, and we got shuttled off, and I saw some people there. All I can do is say I'm sorry. I don't know what else to say. People were just ravaged. We were then shipped off to East, and then picked up by my mother's boyfriend, who took us to a hotel all the way in Cherry Hill. We stayed there for a while. We got heat, we got showers, food, internet, you know. It wasn't normal life. We felt like refugees, forced out of our home. We ended up finding a place in Manchester, and we are currently living there. To be honest, I'm happy with it. It's better than our old house was, the rent's about the same, but it's not our home, and I will not consider that place I live in now a home. My home is still the seaside, and it will be there. It'll stay there. They'll have new people in it, whatever my landlord decides to do, but you know what? That's going to be my home for now on, and I will consider this house I live in now my home.
There's still so much that needs to be done, and the devastation that was caused by Hurricane Sandy is just not going to go away overnight. People think that after the first week of the storm, like, that was it. Like, there's so much that needs to be done still, and so much that needs to be repaired.
Just let me fall into your movements are subtle surrender. I need to recycle all the feelings I had in the past.
Everything at Good Luck Point was really eye-opening and surreal, and to see houses that were destroyed by a hurricane, and in New Jersey no less, like, it just felt like I was somewhere else. Like, those places are places that I've gone to every day of my life. I live here, and to see them destroyed is just something that you see on, like, a movie scene. Like, it just doesn't seem real. Houses, like, burnt down to the ground, I've never seen in my entire life. Like, to think that that can actually happen to someone, and that wasn't even me, and I felt upset about it. Like, that's someone's house. Those are their things inside of that house, and they're all gone now. Like, what are they supposed to do? How are they supposed to get back on their feet? Like, I can never, ever go through that and have that not affect me in any way.
Me and two of my friends came out a week after the storm, and we started doing a cleanup for people out here in some of the areas that got hit the hardest. And I mean, I've never seen anything on this scale. I've lived, you know, all over the country, been through some disasters, and this is the worst I've ever seen. I mean, everybody, you know, I was doing a basement pump out the day after the storm up in Monmouth Beach, and the guy said he'd lived in the same house for 85 years. He was here for the big storm in 62 that everybody always talks about, and he says that even that was nothing on this scale. I mean, we go to entire blocks like this where every single house had feet of water in their first floor. I mean, let alone the basement. It's unbelievable. It really is.
It's important to see those things though. Like, it's important to know what's going on in your area, and you don't know how bad it can get, but it's real. Like, bad things can happen, and they're happening here, and we need to be able to help those who are affected by them.
Displaced because my house was gone, and my dad works at Raritan Center, which is up north a ways. They're a big company. I was the only one related to anybody that worked there that was displaced. They all pulled in money and actually gave me money to buy clothes with.
My house during Hurricane Sandy did not get affected at all, and since it's only me and my mom in my house, we felt like we needed to do something to help out. We looked up shelters, and we found that Central High School was actually holding one. So we decided to come here and check it out and see if we could do anything to help. It was actually really, really life-changing. Like, it's a really big eye-opener to be able to see people that have gone through such great devastation, and like how they've lost their houses, but yet they're so humble and like so willing to still help who they can at the same time as us helping them.
Well, there was FEMA that was everywhere, which you couldn't go anywhere without hearing that, or doing a lot of help to help people. I know the political parties that came and looked at all the, like, they came to Brick and went to Seaside. And I just heard about the Buddhist community that just gave a lot of money to people from Seaside.
I actually went to other shelters outside of our community. We went to Bricktown's police department, and they were holding a shelter there, and it was just to give people warm beds to sleep in, warm clothes, a warm place to stay, and they were serving fresh food every night, and it was cooked by people that were volunteering, and it was all homemade, and it was just really nice that people could do that for someone and just care so much to help out. Like, even after like the first week, people thought like it was over. It really wasn't. Like, there's still, even now, like, there's still so many people that still need help and that don't have homes. Like, there's so much you can do to help out. Like, it's going to continue for a long time. Like, this isn't just gonna end, and we can do something about it.